Hi, welcome to Theory of Computation. In this video session, let's discuss about finite state machines, which is non-deterministic. In the last lecture, we have discussed about the design of deterministic finite state machine. Now let's try and design a finite state machine, which is non-deterministic in nature. And I will explain what is non-deterministic a little later. That will accept exactly those strings that have symbol 1 in the second last position from all binary strings. That is, we have to design a finite state automata in such a way that it accepts all binary strings that have 1 in the second last position. For example, the language might contain the strings like 10, because the length of the string is 10 and we have 1 in the second last position. 11, we have 1 in the second last position. 010, 011, 110, 111, and so on. Okay, wherever we have binary string with 1 in the second last position, the length of the string can be arbitrarily long. Okay, so we have to design a machine that will accept this one, and we are interested in the one in the second last position. Okay, so we'll design a starting state Q naught, which is coming from nowhere, and we assume that it is accepting a one, and we will assume that this one is the second last one that we are looking for in the binary string. And in that case, we will move to Q1. So when we transit from Q0 to Q1, we assume that we have seen a 1 in the second last position. And from Q1 to Q2, we can accept either 0 or 1. Because we are not worried about the last symbol, we are worried only about the second last symbol. So from Q1, we can accept either 0 or 1, and we can move to Q2. Now, since this is the second last symbol, from Q0 we are accepting the second last symbol, and from Q1 we are accepting the last symbol. So Q2 will act as the final state. Now, what are all the things that are missing? We have not accept all binary strings. We have accepted only 10, or it is 11. Okay, these two strings are the things that we are accepting in this finite state machine. We have to make sure that it is accepting all binary strings that is ending with a 1 in the second last position. If we allow the state Q0 to accept either 0 or 1 any number of times, then we are able to generate any binary string. And when we accept a 1 which is in the second last position, we will transit from Q0 to Q1. Otherwise, for all other 1s and 0s, we will simply stay in the state Q0. Okay, so with this machine, we can generate any binary string that will accept the string that has a 1 in the second last position. Say for example, we are trying to accept say 1 1 1 1, 4 ones together, and we have 1 in the second last position. So for these first two ones in the input, we'll start from Q0 and transit 2 times to Q0, and for this one, the third one in the input, we will transit from Q0 to Q1. And for this last one, we will transit from Q1 to Q2. Okay, and thus we can accept this one. Now, what are all the differences that we can observe from the design of deterministic finite state machine? And this is a non-deterministic finite state machine. With deterministic finite state machine, I cannot allow from a single state and for a single symbol transition to two different states. That is, the transition is defined across Q and the sigma, and the output should be a state in Q. But here we have considered the transition from Q naught and the symbol 1, and we are transiting to Q naught as well as we can transit to Q1, either Q naught or Q1. So this is the non-determinism that we are introducing in the design. For a single state and a single symbol, I can move to more than one state, but not at the same time. Either I can move to Q0 or I can move to Q1. One more non-determinism is that from Q2, as soon as we have reached the state Q2, we do not have anything to accept from Q2. That is, after I reach Q2, the machine halts. I cannot accept any 1 or 0. The transition from Q0 is undefined. So this is another non-determinism that we have introduced in the design. But in deterministic finite state machine, from every state we have to define the transition for every symbol. With this scenario, how do we know that for a particular input this machine is accepting an input or not? Okay, so let's consider an example. We are trying to accept the string 01010. So we will start from the starting state, which is Q0, and we are accepting the input 0. So from Q0, if I get a 0, we go back to Q0. So we will go to Q0 again. From Q0, I am accepting the second input 1. Now we have two choices. Either I can choose to stay in the same state Q0, or we can go to the state Q1. So now we'll have two branches. Let's assume that one branch stays in Q0, the other one moves to Q1. And now we get the third input, which is 0. So from Q0, if we get a 0, we go back to Q0. So we go here. And from Q1, if we accept a 0, we go to Q2. And we come here. And the next input is 1. Now from Q0, if we get a 1, we move back to Q0, or we can move to Q1. Again, we will branch. One will stay with Q0, the other goes with Q1. Now what about the branch that we have ended with Q2? From Q2, I cannot accept anything, neither 0 nor 1. So in this case, when we get the next input 1, we are stuck. No more movement from Q2. So we are stuck here. So this path is terminated. So from here, now we get the last input, which is 0. So one branch staying at Q0 will go back to Q0. The other branch, which is at Q1, will go to Q2. That is what is indicated in this one. Now, when we reach the end of the string, okay, one branch is at Q0, the other path is at Q2, and the machine is set to accept the string if we are able to find at least one path that will take the machine from the starting state Q0, and at the end of the input, we reach the final state. So here this path, Q0, 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 Q1, Q2. This path is taking us from the initial state to the final state. So this string is accepted by the non-deterministic finite state machine that we have designed. Now let's formally define the components of non-deterministic finite state automata. Like deterministic finite state machine, here also we have 5 components. The machine M is defined with finite set of states Q and finite set of symbols sigma, the transition functions delta, the starting state Q0, and a finite set of accepting states or final states. And what is the difference between the deterministic finite state machine and the non-deterministic finite state machine? It comes in the form of delta. In deterministic finite state machine, delta is defined as the domain to be Q cross sigma and the range is Q. But with non-deterministic finite state machine, the domain is same as that of the deterministic finite state machine, but the range is the power set of Q, which is 2 power Q, which is represented as 2 power Q, which is nothing but the power set of Q, which is set of all subsets of Q. Now, how do we define the machine that we have defined? How many states we have? We have 3 states, Q0, Q1 and Q2. That is the finite set of states. And the symbols we are dealing is binary. So, we have sigma to be 0 and 1. And the starting state of the machine is Q0. Similar to deterministic finite state machine, we have a single starting state. And the finite set of accepting states include Q2. We have only one final state or the accepting state, which is Q2. And delta, the transitions from Q0, if we have 0, we go back to 0. So, from Q0, if we have 0, we go back to 0. From Q0, if we accept 1, either I can go to Q0 or I can go to Q1. So, this is more than one state. We can move to more than one state. From Q0, when we get 1 as input, either we can go to Q0 or we can go to Q1. And the starting state is indicated by this arrow. And from Q1, if we get 0 or 1, we go to Q2. So, for both the inputs, we go to Q2. And from Q2, which is the accepting state indicated by this star, is not accepting any input. So, it is null. Now, let's extend the transition function to accept the string. Instead of symbol, let's accept the string. The inductive definition goes like this. The basis is from some state Q, if we accept the null string, we say stay in the same state because we do not have any input symbol to make transition. And we know that null is not a part of the input symbol. And the induction definition is, let's consider a string W, which is of the form XA. And X is a string and A is the last symbol of W. Now, the delta cap or the extended transition function from the state Q upon X, we will assume that it is generating a set of states, which is P1, P2, etc. up to PK. That is, starting from some state Q, after accepting X, I can be possibly in one of these states, P1, P2, P3, etc. up to PK. And we will assume that the union of delta of each of the PI, P1 to PK, I ranges from 1 to K, the delta of each of the state upon A, that is what we are computing, and we are making the union of all of that. And assume that this set is some R1, R2, etc. up to Rm. Then we can define that delta cap of Q comma W to be this one, because after accepting X from Q, we are in this state, and for either I can be in P1, P2 or PK. So, from each of the state, if I can find the transition upon A and make a union of all of them, that is the result of starting from Q0, starting from some state Q and accepting the entire string W, which is XA. So, these two sets will be the same. Thus, we have defined the delta cap to be a function which is Q cross sigma star, which is a string, and the range of this is the power set of Q. Now, let's find out what is the transition of the machine that we have designed upon this input 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. So, the starting state is Q0. So, from Q0, if we accept the empty string, Okay, the, in the beginning we have an empty string. So we stay in Q naught. So from Q naught, if we have a 0, we go back to Q naught. Okay, so that is the delta of Q naught comma 0, which is Q naught again. From Q naught, now we have the next symbol 1. So we are trying to find out what happens to the machine after accepting 0, 1 from Q naught. So from this one, okay, so we have, after accepting 0, we have landed in Q naught. So this will be simply delta of Q naught comma 1. Now from Q naught, if we have a 1, either I can go to Q naught or we can go to Q1. So that is what we have written here. Now delta cap of 0, 1, 0 will be the next input symbol. Will be, I have to find the delta of each of these states with the input symbol 0. So we have to write delta of Q naught comma 0 union delta of Q1 comma 0. From Q naught, if we get a 0, we go back to Q naught, and from Q1, if we get a 0, we go to Q2, and that is what we have got here. And when we accept the next input symbol, we have to find the transition of the machine from Q0 and Q2 for the input symbol 1. And we can find that from Q0, if we get a 1, we can go to Q0 or Q1. But when we take Q2, there is no transition, right? So we have Q0, Q1 union null set, which is Q0, Q1. And finally, we have the input 0, so we have to find the transition of this machine upon the input symbol 0. Okay, and we end up with Q0, Q2. Now we can define the language of NFA, that is, given a non-deterministic finite state automata, what is the language it is accepting. Now let M be the machine, which is a non-deterministic finite state automata. The language of M is, L of M equal to set of all W's, that is set of all strings from sigma star, such that delta cap of Q naught comma W, that is when we start from Q naught and accept the string W, we end up with a set of states. And that set intersection F should not be equal to null. That is, the states that we have here should have at least one of the final states. That is, the language of M is set of all strings W in sigma star, such that the delta cap of Q naught comma W contains at least one of the accepting states. That is what this means. The intersection should not be equal to null. At least this shape, delta cap of Q naught comma W, should have one element from the F,